Hi everyone, Ian Van Tile here, and we are currently on board the brand new Virtus 420 built by Bavaria. This is a flybridge 42-foot vessel that is absolutely innovative in its own design. So let me show you some of the features and benefits about this yacht.
So first thing here, looking at the Virtus 420 from the stern, is this is one large swim platform here. This particular swim platform actually lowers down. These are the retractable steps that bring you down to the swim platform when it was down in the water itself. You can also mount rails here as well too, and house a dinghy. As we walk up forward, I'm going to come to the port side of the vessel, but you're going to see this kind of ring cutout design here. Actually, what this does is it's very, very innovative. The table and the chairs could actually slide into different positions all around the transom of this vessel, this aft cockpit, and really open it all up, but also kind of go into the standard platform as you see here, where the chairs are, bench seats, I should say, are just situated center line, table center line, and then there's also two stools. Underneath these bench seats, these lift up, and there's storage built underneath these as well too. There are nice large stainless steel access gates that close off the cockpit, really nice access points to the cleats itself, and just the attention to detail and the trim work is pretty phenomenal. Little cubbies found on both sides, and then I'm going to take you up to the side deck. Really nice built-in handles with great designs, leading yourself up to wide side decks. Overhead we have handles here as well, so you have a good secure footing as you're walking up to the foredeck. The foredeck is quite nice. It has a large lounge pad up here. We have the center one removed just so you have light down in the forward cabin, but this is a phenomenal mattress that just is enabling you to have a great lounge and usable space up here on the foredeck. Really high-end fender holders here on both starboard and port side. We have the electric windlass with anchor locker here and a bow seat. Looking aft gives you a nice profile of the design of the flybridge. Large wraparound windshields. We have a spotlight. There's a horn as well too, or an speaker mic. And then again, these nice large wide side decks make the maneuverability around the vessel quite pleasing and easy. Steps back into the aft cockpit. Again, huge points here is a large swim platform, a large aft cockpit. Now I'm going to take you up to the flybridge. And one thing I also want to point out is this innovative design. You can see how the different cutouts are, but it really is quite nice coming up to the flybridge, and it really gives you a great feel as you do so without taking up too much space. Here on the flybridge, this is really impressive. Look at this large U-shaped seating here with this table that can be removed if so desired. Underneath this box here is storage, a built-in refrigerator here. This is an ice maker. And then top is our sink. You can also have an electric grill here if so desired. We have a TV antenna. This is our Simrad radar navigation light VHF antenna. A nice two-tone seating arrangement, but really impressive with a large overhead bimini. Also notice the Flexi-Teak decks as well too. As we come up here to the helm, we have a forward-facing helm seat, but this also converts so it could have some maneuverability as well too in the seating position. You have a nice little lounge pad up forward of that. Double helm seat facing forward. I really like this opening center skylight, built-in cup holders. And then here at the helm itself, we have our bow thruster controllers, our air horn. These are our engine displays. Large Simrad chart plotter, our quick windlass controller so you can retrieve and deploy the anchor from here, and then our Volva Penta displays. We have our throttle controls, our trim tabs, and then also our joystick controller here. So really well done. Sitting here at the helm, we have plenty of space. I'm right at 6 foot, so you can see where my knees are. Tons of room here and phenomenal visibility everywhere you go. I really like that, whether you're standing up or sitting down. All right, so let's move our way back down. Before I do so, I also want to point out that this is a closable hatch as well too. So if you have younger kids when you're up above here, or animals, you can close this off for safety. Obviously, the true way to go downstairs is backwards, but again, with the cutouts, and I'm just showing you from this, it is so easy to maneuver those stairs. That's really impressive here on this design. This is the swim platform control, so this is the up and down, so you can raise and lower the swim platform. We also have engine room access right below this hatch here. Large spanning windows that all slide off to one side, or you can split them if so desired as well too. But this is a great entryway into our salon. Here in the salon is a large L-shaped seating off to starboard side. We have this large galley entertainment system. There's a pop-up television here. Behind this door, this is a large refrigerator, freezer compartment. We have a storage stereo compartment here. Just behind this one is another refrigerator freezer compartment. We have our built-in microwave, and then our trash can and additional storage. Double stainless steel sinks, two burner electric stovetop, but look at this countertop space, really impressive. Large windows, beautiful LED overhead lighting as well too, that just really light this up. But when you're here in the salon, it's just so, you know, phenomenal headroom. I'm saying at least 7 foot headroom. And just lots of natural light. And then I love it how they've kind of built this up. And this is where that opening hatch is from the flybridge. Also have additional cabinetry here and very, very well laid out. Here is the lower helm station. Again, innovative steps. So you kind of utilize the space, but you know, great handholds here. We have our VHF controls, our throttle controls, trim tab controls. This is our generator start stop switch. Our joystick controls, the ignition system, bow thruster, fireboy suppression system. This is the VHF. Controls to the upper spotlight. Our engine displays, this will show us our RPMs and so forth, along with these standard gauges. Centrally located, Simrad chart plotter, same as up above. Fusion stereo remote. And then what we have here, this C-Zone, this is really cool. So this allows us to kind of toggle through and turn on and off all of the systems throughout the vessel itself. So very, very modern, very easy to use. And again, it'll allow us to show what our fresh water is, to turn on, all of the refrigeration, stereo systems, lighting throughout the vessel. So a really nice display, easy access and easy to use. And the other point is, you know, you can be here at the helm. You have good headroom to stand up, you know, if so desired. And again, I like that overhead opening hatch. So let's go down below. As we come down below, we have three gradual steps. Nice handholds here. This is the dark walnut wood interior. Off to the port side is our day head and shower or guest cabin. These are Jabsco electric quiet flush toilets. Really nice vessel sinks here. Large mirrors, opening hatch here, and a full walk-in shower. This is a really impressive shower compartment. So I like the use of space here. They've really done a nice job in a very respectable guest cabin head. As we move up forward, just behind this door here, this is one of two aft staterooms. This particular stateroom here has a little lower head profile, just for headroom, just because there is all that cabinetry above. But there is two berths here, and you can put the filler cushion in to make it a large Marine Queen berth. And then you have an over and above storage hanging locker here. And then we're gonna move across to the starboard side to our VIP cabin. The VIP cabin has a lot more headroom, as you can see. It also offers the ability to have a filler cushion put in here to make it a large Marine Queen berth, or you can have it set up here just as you see here with two reading lights and, you know, really nice, respectable cabin. I like the finishing here, the materials that are used, just that high lockered kind of trim. There's an opening port here, lots of storage and hanging locker space. As we move up forward, I'm going to close this door, but a full length mirror as well too. All right, let's go to the master. So here on the master, we have a really nice cabinet here as we come in. Actually, this part opens up, is like a little vanity area here, but lots of drawers. But take a look at this master. incredible headroom, really nice V-berth here. And again, lots and lots of space as we kind of look over to the port side. Excuse me. Yeah, the port side, we have a hanging locker here, large windows with opening ports, this, you know, black lacquered trim, and just really nice, you know, lighting throughout. The headboard itself has mirrors on both sides of it, reading lights, and they've just done a really nice job of just appointing this. There is a full length mirror here as well too. And as we walk over to the starboard side, we have its own private head and shower compartment. So here you have the sink, a large mirror, a nice you know, rack here for towels. Behind the door is the Japsco Quiet Flush freshwater toilet, opening hatch, and then a full, again, walk-in shower. This is, again, in my, you know, my mind, really impressive here. Lots of space when this door is closed off here. And just a really well-designed head compartment that's found in the master cabin here. Again, real thick doors, you know, they close really nicely. It's just all of the woodwork and finishing is quite nice. Something that you'd find in a German engineered yacht. All right, so we do have subsoil storage underneath these steps. These lift up, and then you have additional storage down here. And then again, as we walk back into the salon. Well, I hope you found this video walkthrough to be helpful and informative. Again, this is the very first Vertes 420 that we have in inventory that we brought over from Germany. It's on display right now at the Newport Beach International Boat Show, and it is currently available and located in Southern California. So if you would like more information, please contact me at any time, day or night. I look forward to getting you on board this vessel and showing you the incredible introductory pricing. If you like the video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't already, subscribe to my channel for additional video walkthroughs. Thank you again, and I look forward to hearing from you, hopefully earning your business and getting you, your friends, and your family out on the water on this amazing vessel. Thank you again.